advances in cancer diagnosis and the introduction of new cancer treatments have dramatically improved the odds of survival, permitting patients and practitioners to think well beyond cure to the future quality of life. Although cancer is often thought as a disease of aging, the number of young patients whose reproductive futures may be affected by the cancer treatment is remarkable. And also the evidences says the same thing that the chance of achieving a pregnancy in a cancer survivor females was 20% lower when the cancer was diagnosed in a childhood, and it was 50% lower when the cancer was diagnosed in the adult as a young adult phase as compared to the female siblings without cancer. And of course, the survival statistics says that approximately 85% of the prepubertal cancer patients are likely to survive. So the discussion point is, because of all this, we need to really understand and focus on the late effects of cancer treatments, which are mainly reproductive and endocrine issues, difficulty transitioning through the puberty, delayed development of secondary sexual characteristics, cardiac dysfunction, and neurocognitive impairment. So, we will discuss, of course, in this workshop, we will focus on these survivorship issues of fertility concerns and desire to have family. And it has been said in many literatures that one of the strongest predictors of emotional well-being of cancer survivors is parenthood, representing return to normalcy and sense of fulfillment. And receiving specialized counseling about reproductive loss and the fertility preservation is associated with less regret and greater quality of life for the survivor, stressing upon the importance of fertility preservation. And nowadays, the international standard of care, which has been mentioned on many which has been mentioned in the guidelines by many international organizations like ESCO, ASRM, ESHRE, Fertility Consortium, is to provide clear and consistent information about the impact of cancer treatment on fertility and fertility preservation options where there is a curative intent. So I would just in brief, I would like to take you upon this clinical pathway for oncofertility care. So when it is there is a decision about the fertility threatening treatments with the patient, definitely the first point of contact would be oncologist, rheumatologist, or other healthcare providers, where they have to assess the need for the fertility preservation. That is the first and foremost thing that has to be documented well. Fertility risks of the treatment is important to document, and the particular counseling regarding all this has to be given, provided to the patient. It can be with this we are talking about the whenever at the first contact, and then they will be referring these patients to the oncofertility consultation reference to the fertility units. So the first part is the first team, which is in the direct contact with the patient initially. And then there is something called oncofertility navigator, or a person who is constantly in contact with the patient, with the oncology team, as well as the fertility team. And that person will take care referral of this patient in right time without any delays. These people, they are very much approachable to the patient also, as well as the doctors also, and they will also help patients into the insurance or cost factors and everything. And then the patient will be in contact with the fertility specialist. At the same time, the psychologist, if needed, so counseling session by the psychologist, financial counselor to understand the cost implications. If required, genetic counseling. And then again, the risks are assessed, fertility potentials are assessed, and particular preservation options are given, and accordingly, the procedures are carried out, where again, patients will be in contact with the fertility specialist, anesthesiologist, the lab persons, that is the embryologist, and as well as the nurses. So basically, this is the actual referral pathway. So I just wanted to stress upon here the role of the coordinator or navigator, which is very, very important. So this coordinator person will be coordinating with the oncological team, clinical care team, fertility preservation team, patient simultaneously, as well as to maintain the data for the research. And of course, the doctors, though the team should have the direct contact at the same time. So definitely, I would like to just stress upon the important points which are necessary when there is a handover of the patient from oncology to the fertility team. So these points are very important. Those are like brief history of the patient, developmental maturity of the patient, planned treatment. This is very important. The prognosis of the disease, and importantly, the urgency. That means the clear indication of acceptable time frame, which helps in choosing the correct way of the treatment. For especially, I'm talking about for the fertility specialist, which protocols to be used. Then handover of the patient and family's understanding of the diagnosis, prognosis, fertility preservation options, what was the initial discussion, and response to introductory discussion. Other procedures which are planned, then requirement for the menstrual separation, then other factors which are pertinent to the cancer and reproductive potential. And for example, like likelihood of the radiotherapy, likelihood of the relapse, and factors that may specifically increase the surgical risks, like mediastinal mass or battle scarred abdomen or significant immune suppression, bleeding disorders, and some abdominal or detroperitoneal mass, etc. And social concerns within the family, like custody issue or parental disagreement. So that is important. So in at the end, I would like to just share this diagram, which is from the ESHRE guideline for the fertility preservation. So we have to focus ultimately on designing a model of care for the fertility preservation, where it is the patient-centric approach, giving the constant support and counseling to the patient, and with the direct communication between the oncology and as well as the fertility team. So here, clinical care team is the first team in the direct contact with the patient. That is the oncology team, which will give the primary information, at least the discussion about the options available for the fertility preservation. And after the baseline assessment and planning of the cancer treatment, the patients will be referred to the FP team, that is the counselors and the fertility specialist, where again the assessment happens with respect to the patient's general health, risks of the fertility, risk to the fertility, as well as the assessment of the fertility potentials, then what kind of treatments to be chosen, and what would be the challenges in those treatment, what interventions are required. Accordingly, those fertility preservations would be undertaken, and again, the patient will be referred back to the clinical care team for the cancer treatments. And also very important to understand that once it is all cured after a few years, then again, this circle has to be completed, where again, there is a coordination, and we need to discuss about the timing of the pregnancy, fitness of the pregnancy, when to go back to have the pregnancy, and what are the parenting options, other options. So that has to be completed. So this is our ideally aim to design such kind of the model for giving our patients good quality of life. So to summarize my this session, I would like to stress upon these points that all patients and families have the right to know if their fertility is at risk because of the disease, that is because of the cancer as well as the cancer treatments. Even if there is no time to do anything about it, there is nothing that can be done, prognosis is poor, or we do not think it is a good idea or necessary to preserve the fertility. When it is judged to be medically safe by all relevant teams, with our information and support, the decision then rests with the patient and the family. then documenting the discussion in the medical record is very much mandatory. The documentation should be with the oncological team also, as well as the fertility team also. And providing the written resources, written information to the families is also very much important. So thank you so much.